For many people, electric cars are the preferred choice for providing zero emissions mobility. But electric cars do not always run on renewable energy. To better match the supply and demand of renewables and create value for EV users, Jetlix was started in 2015. So let's assume you drive an EV. When you get home in the evening, you connect your car to your home charger. Your car is already linked to the Jetlix app. Using that, you can set the time to leave in the morning. While you're sleeping, the app checks when renewable energy is available, like when the sun shines or there is a lot of wind. At the best moment, your car will be charged. That's extra sustainable and the prices are better. The generated savings will be returned to you and in the morning your car is fully charged. But can users access this smart charging facility at other charging points? Currently in the Netherlands, charging at more than 1,000 public charging points is supported by the Jetlix smart charging app. Even better, if you own a Tesla, you can charge at home using Jetlix. With this, Jetlix makes a direct connection to your car and works regardless of the charging connection type. Very soon, this service will also be launched with BMW and Renault. Ultimately, Jetlix's goal is to make its smart charging facility accessible to every electric car driver, and so the company continues to work towards supporting more and more brands and models of electric cars.
My name is Taco van Berkel. I'm one of the people who initiated Jetlix, smart charging service. I think 6 years ago, I was selling charging stations for EVs. Nowadays, everybody does. So a couple of years ago, together with some other guys from a bigger utility, we ran into, let's say, the connected car and IoT and decided to do it differently, to actually see the car as the asset to control. But you just did it. And here we are. We are a live service with smart charging. And within Jetlix, I'm the one who is actually the contact person for car manufacturers. So I'm knocking on the doors of all those people building cars and, well, try to inform them first about the smart charging and the energy industry, and then, of course, seduce them to work with us.
My name is Irma Stegman. I'm a business analyst for Jetlix. I've been involved with their activities for over a year now. I started by doing a graduation project there about trading flexibility for on distribution level for aggregators of electrical vehicles. Jetlix started a few years back at a large supply company of electricity in the Netherlands. They are one of the biggest producers of renewable energy. And they were already working on a lot of IoT projects, so Internet of the Future, involved with that in smart houses. And this was basically the next step to be made in the future of sustainable electric mobility.
Well, the idea was quite old. I think it's not ours. It's about time of use. So I think the energy industry actually is not much longer about kilowatt hours or volume. It's about the time of use of energy. Well, as I'm driving an electrical car myself, I tend to be in my bed for 8 hours and I only need 4 hours to charge my car. So there you are, there's flexibility. And the second question is how to use this flexibility for charging your car. That's quite plain as well. Just charge the car when the prices are lowest at those moments. And that's usually when the wind blows or when the sun shines. So far, so good. And then it's turned out that there are, I think, a couple of hundred charge point operators in Europe where we are based. I think worldwide must be thousands of charge point operators. So to involve them all in smart charging, it's a little bit far-fetched. But there's only 10 or maybe 12 big car manufacturers worldwide. So we decided to start there. So I think the first car we did was a Tesla, and with 10 big car manufacturers building EVs these days, that was already 10% of the market we had. We started with one Tesla, charged it for 2 or 3 months, and it turned out we could make 15, 20, sometimes 25 euros a month for the end user by doing nothing, by just, let's say, controlling the charging during nighttime when he was asleep or she was asleep. And then in the morning the car was charged, which happened all the time, and now it was smart charged. So by doing nothing, actually gaining 15 to 20 euros a month, well, it's quite an achievement. And then we decided, oh, this must be a business. So now it's our business, and now we've actually elaborated the service a little bit to Renault, BMW, and some car manufacturers I cannot mention yet.
The way that Jetlix at this moment incentivizes end users to make use of our services, so flexibility services, our smart charging services, is by trading their flexibility, which means that they have a car that needs to be charged, but it doesn't have to be charged right at the moment once you plug in their car at a charging station. So what we do is we use this flexibility as a balancing service for transmission system operators, distribution system operators, and balance responsible parties. And with that, we create revenues on the electricity market. And on the other hand, we also work together with car manufacturers, and we provide them services for their end users to make smart charging possible. So with these revenues, we finally share this profit that we make with our users. So what we see at the moment is that customers that are heavy commuters, they can gain up to 15 euros per month by smart charging. But as I said, this is something that we see at the moment. It's also possible that these savings are increased over time. And if you look at services such as V2G, the revenues can even be improved. But it's all depending on what happens with battery technology, if the characteristics of batteries will allow us to really make use of this possibility. And in addition, also the costs for bidirectional chargers, the costs for actually being able to discharge your car, all these technologies and the pricing of these technologies will eventually make this possibility come true.
So for now, we focus on the use case of overnight charging when people are asleep or at least at home. I don't know what they're doing there. Or in the office on daytime. So we call this harbor charging. These are the locations where your harbor is, where you will be for a longer period of time and have more time to charge than you need. So actually we ask people in a kind of set and forget user interface to give us their default departure time. So if you're leaving the house between 7 and 8 in the morning, we say to people, please enter 7 o'clock in your app or in the Jetlix app. And we will make sure it's charged. So this is actually the thing we do. We learn a lot from these people, because if we see them departing earlier, we'll notify them, like, maybe we should change your default setting. Or if we see them leaving later default, then we can say, well, you might be able to actually add more to renewable energy world and save more money by adjusting your departure time. So the interaction with the end user is actually focused on this departure time. The trick for us is not only in algorithms, because our algorithm will make sure that the charging is optimized up until departure. But the most important thing is that there is a service which is actually gaining the trust from the end user. And for this reason, there's something else very important. It's direct charging. So we've learned from end users, they want to charge, let's say, like 10, 12, maybe 50 kilometers directly. Why? Your mother is sick, or you want to go to hospital in the night, or want to be able to go there. So the first part of charging is most of the time direct charging. And then the rest of the charging, the remaining capacity of the battery, which still has to be charged, this is left for flexibility, regarding, of course, your departure time. And maybe in the farther future, when batteries get very large, like maybe 1,000 kilometers range, maybe then we say to people, well, maybe you don't need 1,000 kilometers. Maybe you only need what you need to consume the next day. One of the challenges we face is that it's double new. So it's two times new. EV driving is new, charging is new. So the basics of electric mobility is all new to them, to people. Plugging, etc. And then on top of that, we ask people to say, well, give us your flexibility. So making people aware what flexibility is, that it, for instance, can be provided best when you are at one of your harbor locations, like at home or at your workplace, locations where you will spend a lot of time, your car will be on the charger for a longer period of time, that's where you can provide flexibility to the energy industry, which is worth something. So that's one. So it's more awareness. The second challenge is also on the user side is making services seamlessly. So asking people for a departure time, which is quite default, and kind of coaching people to provide us their departure time. Well, it's a challenge, but we're getting there. I think the next thing will be to integrate such services into the services of car manufacturers. So there's already services of car manufacturers within an app, which does do something with the preheating of your car and your battery, or the cooling. Integrating those services in one seamless service, which really fits your profile, your mobility profile, your planning of the day. That's quite a challenge, but a fun challenge.
For us, it's very interesting to see that more people are adapting to electrical vehicles and then hopefully also adapting to smart charging. And one of the challenges we see there is that there are a lot of benefits to using electrical vehicles, but there are also some negative parts. And one of the things we see is that charging your electrical vehicle can have a large impact on the distribution network. This means low voltage cables or medium voltage cables. And therefore, one of the challenges we see is to get a proper market established on the distribution level. And we're already working together with a lot of DSOs on pilot projects, but we're also very much looking forward to see what's going to happen there and how the market will probably be established on that level.
Extremely proud is actually that it's a live commercial service, and commercial in the proudness is not about the money we make, because obviously we have to make some money to exist and want to be successful as a company. But as we are a startup or a scale-up, the commercial thing is more that commercially it's something that's scalable. So we're very, very proud that we have something which is scalable, that the bigger car manufacturers are working with us, and we see more and more energy utilities are actually lining up, calling us, how can we join actually your schemes and work together. So yeah, we're very proud of those ones.